Hi everyone, today we are going to understand the sales process on the various products which are sold by most of the IT companies and IT product development companies in the business. So let us understand how does the sales process work. For example, if you're selling your product or a solution to your customers, what is the process to be followed and how it can be done effectively into today's session. So let's get started. Now we have different stages or various stages on the product sales process. The first one would be the lead stage, the second one would be the opportunity stage, and the third one would be deal or a closure stage. So let us understand each one by one to understand briefly like how does the process work and how we can do it in a more better way. So first thing is the lead stage. In the lead stage, first thing what we do is we qualify the leads. You all know that the lead flow will be through outbound and inbound process. So there will be two ways where we get a lead, and once that we get a lead, then leads will be qualified by the any company's internal sales personnel. And once the lead is qualified with a quick R&D about the prospect, their background, a quick discovery call with a 30 minutes meeting is initiated to understand all this process. And during this meeting, sales personnel must understand the prospect business process and ecosystem. So if you're not understanding the prospect very well, then it will be a great problem for any sales personnel to go to the next step. So it's always a good idea to understand the prospect, to understand in and out of the prospect, their business process, their ecosystem, from start to the end, and how our solution could help them would ideally be in this discovery call. And after the discovery call or a meeting is set up, a demo call is scheduled within a week's time, keeping the lead warm. So once you see that there's a requirement, or you find that their business process is right fitment, our solution is the right fitment to their business process, then definitely it is always a good idea to show your product or solution demo to them along with your the subject matter expert or a technical lead, which will have the product in action, so that the prospect will get a better understanding of the product and he can see it live in action to have the process before his eyes, before letting him take the decision, right? And the next step would be demo completion. In this, the next action items are discussed: when to follow up, what would be the next steps from the prospect, and how soon are they looking for this kind of product or solution, and are they in market looking out for other vendors who offer the same solution or product. This would always add more value, more understanding about your prospects and their discovery, because most of the the end client or a prospects always are in market. If they are looking in a market similar kind of solution, then this process would really help, right? Hope you got some quick understanding about the lead stage. So the next process would be the opportunity stage. The opportunity is definitely a very interesting thing for any organization, and once the demo is completed, it's always a good idea to follow the BANT principle in marketing. So how do we categorize the lead depending on the BANT? What is BANT? See, the BANT is typically defined as a budget, authority, need, and timeline. So you need to make sure that your BANT is on to the point. So you have identified an opportunity. Now you have to understand their budget, if they have any relevant budget for this solution or a product, and if it suits your internal budget planning as well. And the next thing is authority. Are you talking to the right authority or the key decision maker who would take the authority within the timeline, right? Next is the need. How soon they have this need is very important, like 3 months, 2 months, 6 months. So this will always help to close the deal and create a great opportunity for yourself and your organization, right? So all this, once the parameters are met, then a opportunity is qualified and it could go to the next stage which is the deal. In deal process, it is very easy because once the opportunity identified, then it is moved to various sub stages in the opportunity stage itself. The first one would be the opportunity won, and second one would be the opportunity lost, etc. So once the opportunity is won, it will definitely, it is a win for you and it's a deal for the organization, right? And if it is opportunity lost, then that is lost, and the opportunity is lost of various reasons. For example, there is no relevant budget, or you're not talking to the right point of contact, and it may be delayed due to several reasons, and it is above beyond your timelines. Maybe some prospects say they are looking for the solution after a year, which doesn't make sense to follow up with them this year and keep moving it, you know, on a temporary basis. The next thing is, once it is won, then it is a good idea to move to the customer success team if you have internally within your organization, where the customer success team would build a prerequisites documentation, and then followed by a client engagement process wherein all the documentation part, invoicing, the pricing, everything happens, right? And once the opportunity is lost, it will be moved back to the sales and marketing personnel for periodic follow-ups and regular engagement from using the different collaterals, brochures, etc. So hope this sales process of any product will definitely help you, and we look forward that you crack more deals. All the best. Thank you.